when you're in a place like this that has so much history and so much Roman architecture and so much beauty and so much power, you kind of need to just kind of look reasonably smart in a very beautiful setting and hope that it carries you home.
When we decided that we wanted to make Paul, one of the first conversations that happened was where we were going to shoot it. And I was just banging the drum and I just was saying Malta, 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 because of the experience at Risen.
Really, it's an incredible place. The sets that are already standing, as far as from Gladiator, from Agora, from Troy, are incredible. The historical structures that are on the island are just, they're amazing, and something that you could never recreate in a studio.
Yeah, so our starting point on the movie is really to talk with the DOP and the costume designer about the tone and look of the period, what we're trying to do with the styles and the colors. We wanted to give it a musicality, a tonal range between the characters, to subtly delineate the different sets and the different characters and the moods that they're in and the sort of positions that they're going through, the things that are happening to them in the film. And we started with St. Elmo as a location, which is our community base. From these sketches and drawings, we talk to the costume designer and we get the palette together here with some of the costumes. We choose all the colors and the textures. We have some references from other movies and artworks that we like with the DOP, Gerardo, to talk about the lighting. And then that gives it a whole look of this one set.
You know, Dave Arrowsmith was a production designer that I'd never worked with before. And he came off of a big Musketeer show that he did for the BBC. And we looked at that show and we thought that he was really brilliantly gifted in period design work. And it was obvious from the very get-go when he looked at the locations and literally on the spot made sketches in his book. He'd photograph it and sketch it right in his book, that he had his arms around what this movie needed to look like. And his ability to integrate not only set and set design, but wardrobe, props, all of the creative elements that make up this period so faithfully. He is as talented in what he does as Jim Caviezel or James Faulkner or any of our actors in what they do.
We decided before all the different tones for every ambience, no? So all the shade of red for this Romance world, all the white desert color for Damascus, for the Mauritius home, we will use just the cold tones. There isn't light in his private life.
It is amazing, the international palette. We've got Irish, Italian, Serbian, German, American. It's all over the place. But it's really been amazing to watch everybody come behind the story. Everyone sees that the message of forgiveness, of redemption, of grace is so important for the world today, that it's been really easy. And at times you want to be intimidated because you've got James Faulkner on set, who's this unbelievable Shakespearean, classical actor, and Jim Caviezel, who's a huge celebrity. And yet they have such a heart to get the story right that it's been really simple for me. It's made my job very easy.
Everything has just been exactly what we needed for this story and the scale of story we're trying to tell.